Hey guys, welcome back. In today's video, I will show you what kind of brushes I use, and I will also show you what kind of brushes you should get to start painting. So, you better stay tuned. I'm Toby. This channel here is all about showing you how to draw and paint. So, make sure you hit the subscribe button here not to miss any new episode. So, we're now gonna go over the old brushes in detail, and we're gonna start with the underpainting brush here, very broad one, very cheap one. It's just good enough for the underpainting, but it works pretty fine. Next flat ones that we have are these two here. And these are basically, these are flats, but I use them mainly for blending. And I guess you already have seen this one, this famous blender brush here. And when it comes to using a blender brush, choosing a blender brush, you should try to get one that is really soft. And this is, I think, the main key for a blender brush. No matter if it's big or small, it should be pretty soft. Then we have the selection of the flats that I'm using. Some also kind of different brands and sizes, as you can see. Bigger ones, smaller ones, and even tiny ones here. And I think these brushes do the main job on my paintings. And yeah, you can use synthetic brushes like this one here. It's a bit harder. Or you can use this real hair brush flat kind of thing here. And these are also very nice when it comes to applying the color very thin and very flat. Then we got a whole bunch of those fine brushes here. Like this one here. For example, to put in some hair detail or something else in this direction. Got this kind of wigger brush thing here that I have here. And I'm using these ones for reefs and other bigger things that still need to be detailed. Then we got a selection of special brushes that I bought. Basically, in this case here, for details when it comes to painting trees or plants. Basically, the brush is thinned out on the top. And the other one is a dagger brush. This you can apply the color pretty broad, but also very detailed. Then we have, of course, the fan brushes here. Also, size-wise, from small to big. And you see this one is already a bit thinned out to achieve another effect. And then we come to the self-made brushes, like this one here. It's basically just a big brush where I took out some hair and I glued this hair to some stick kind of thing here. And this is excellent for painting long reefs or long detail on plants or something else, hair detail. Then we have some more self-made or custom-made or optimized brushes here. As you can see, it is a bit cut away here. And with this brush I apply spots and small color dots on plant details, any grass or trees or something like that. Same goes for this brush here. It's also a bit thinned out and it's pretty rough and ragged, and this allows me to put in the color pretty nice randomly. So if I would have to pick just 10 brushes to paint with, I think I would go for following ones. Blender brush, three flats, a fan brush, four small detail brushes, and this special deal brush here, ding ding, for putting in those small dots and details and trees, plants, and yeah, I think that would be. And you see, it doesn't take too much money or material to get started. Just get some brushes and get started. So see you next time, and perhaps meanwhile you might also like to check out one of these two videos here.